Hey, what's going on, guys? I'm Dr. P, and welcome back today for another Fortnite video. Now, today, guys, I want to go over a couple of big leaks that we have gotten just in the past couple hours that could potentially be very big for the future of the game. So, as always, I want to get your opinions on it. I'm gonna be gifting people some skins for free on a video very soon. All you need to do to give yourself a chance to win and be selected is send me a friend request on my Epic Games account. It's PineapplezYT, and incidentally enough, that's also my supported creator tag, so if you're buying any V-Bucks anytime soon to cop some of the new 6 skins that are coming out, be sure to give me some support. I'd really appreciate that. Drop a like on the video and subscribe if you're new, and with that said, let's dive into this thing, guys. So let's start off with a cloud slash iceberg update. As you guys know, it is confirmed at this point, there's going to be an ice storm and there's going to be an iceberg coming in alongside of the cloud out at sea. It looks like there's a whole bunch of fog rising, and I'm wondering, along with Fort Tory on Twitter, if we're waiting for the fog to lift and reveal the iceberg. I feel like there are going to be massive icebergs out there. I mean, if you actually look into the reflection of the water, at certain angles, you can see just how big the iceberg on the other side is. It's massive, and I think there are a lot of them. You know, there have been a lot of different reports and a lot of files gotten from the coding that suggest there are going to be numerous different icebergs. So I'm very curious as to what's actually going to happen. It looks like we're going to have not one, but multiple icebergs, as well as a massive ice storm coming to the island very soon. If you take a look at the size of the snow cloud when it was first spotted a little over a week ago, maybe 10 days, something like that, here it is. And then if you compare that with the actual size of it today, you can definitely tell there's no question about it at this point. There's no arguing the fact that it has gotten bigger, and it appears to be getting closer along with the iceberg each and every passing day. Lots and lots of people have heard a strange clinking sound, just a strange sound, an unusual audio cue in Fortnite. Lots of people have been coming into my mentions on Twitter and saying that, and then I saw Obey Trizzo tweet out the same thing. And then FBR_news on Twitter said he heard the same thing too, and he suggests it might be the iceberg that is getting closer and closer. It very well could be the case. I mean, I have heard some strange sounds in Fortnite before. There was the jet plane that people could hear over and over, and now you've got this. I'm not sure what it is. I'm not even exactly sure how to describe it. It was just an unusual sound that you could tell right away was not natural. Definitely in the comment section down below, let me know if you've heard anything out of the ordinary. It's actually a pretty big question I have. It's very important, so please, if you can, just let me know. In yesterday's video, I talked about a leak that suggested there was going to be something called a hamburger event in the game. Now, at the time, I didn't really know what that meant. I didn't even know how to start to piece that together. But there's actually something interesting. There's a game file in the coding that is straight up attached to the hamburger event, one of the main files, and if you run it through a spectrogram, you actually get the logo that AIM has on his parachute and on his shoulder. So whatever this hamburger event is, it's most likely gonna be heavily involved with AIM. It might be one of the main reasons he's here. It might be the way Season 6 ends. We still aren't really sure what AIM is doing or why he's here, but I just realized something that blew my mind, okay? He is technically called the Hunting Party skin. End of the Week 11 loading screen, it looks like he's hunting a party. I know, it's crazy, right? And for that reason, I think this loading screen in particular might be one of the most important, if not the most important one, we've gotten up to this point. I just need to figure out why, and I feel like a lot of it has to do with the coordinates that are right there in the middle. G8, G9, H8, and H9. As I stated in yesterday's video, those coordinates on the Fortnite map actually take you to Fatal Fields, which is interesting. I wonder if something is going to happen to Fatal Fields, and honestly, I would bet so at this point. It looks like it. I think that is very important, you know, the hunting party skin actually going to a party, and apparently he's hunting someone. I mean, look at the way he's crouched over in that corner trying his best to hide. It definitely looks like he's a predator of some sort, hunting someone. The theory is Calamity, because Calamity's appeared in both of the loading screens, that he's appeared like a creep, which have been both of the last two. But nonetheless, I really want to see what happens with those coordinates. I've seen some people say that those are the coordinates of the upcoming snow biome, you know, kind of how, like, we have the desert biome right now where Moisty Mire used to be. They're saying this could be a snow biome where it's snowing there. But that seems like a really small area for the snow to be contained to, so I don't know, we'll see what happens. So Fortnite actually put in a new part of Save the World, a new second part of the Canny Valley questline. There's actually something that looks a lot like a rift from Battle Royale in that game mode. In fact, it is a rift, and the coloration of it is purple. It's straight purple, the exact same shade of purple as Kevin the Cube was. Now, if you'll recall, right before the Cube event, the Cube slash Butterfly event, a little earlier this month, Donald Mustard actually had a tweet that said this was the end of the beginning. Donald Mustard actually went on Twitter with the announcement of the new Save the World questline and said, the next chapter is here. Now, this could be as innocent as him saying, yeah, the next part of Save the World is here, or it could be something deeper than that. It seems like, you know, the end of the beginning and then the next chapters here are good tweets to complement each other. That's a good tweet to have after you say the end of the beginning. And also, if what he said was true and it truly was the end of the beginning, then wouldn't that mean Kevin the Cube wouldn't be completely gone forever? I mean, think about it. I think that makes sense. I feel like we'll get to see Kevin the Cube in some way, shape, or form again. I mean, he left behind a whole bunch of his fragments in the middle of Leaky Lake. Who knows what could happen with them? So I've saved the best for last. Take this with a huge grain of salt. Of everything that gets leaked, this is one of the least likely things to happen. But who knows, man? We'll see. There's actually something in the game's coding right now called Client Pilot Scenarios / Destroy Tilted Towers. This isn't the first time Tilted has been rumored in some way to be deleted. It was rumored to be hit by the meteor, and then it was rumored to be hit by the rocket, and it almost was. But to make a long story short, we have expected the destruction of Tilted Towers several times now, and it's still standing just as good as ever. The thing though about this leaked bit of coding is it is designated and attached to a bunch of robots that are configurable in some manner to attack things. Now the first second I read that, I thought of AIM, of course. He is a robot. It looks like he's being very robotic with his manners. He's landing, he's immediately doing the very basic things, just completing his task, which we don't really know what it is, but maybe it's to kill someone. Also, on top of that, his description literally is just so robotic. Scanning for targets, ... It seems like AIM would be willing to murder a whole bunch of people in Fortnite if he was just, you know, if the flip was just switched. I'm sure someone is controlling him at that point. In fact, that's what my theory is. I think someone is controlling AIM, controlling him to go and do something bad for the map. It could be good too, though. I mean, he could be just trying to warn people of the iceberg and the storm that are coming. But you know what? There's no way to know for sure, and it looks like we're gonna have to wait. Fortunately, though, we're not going to have to wait long. Something's going to happen in the next week at most. I'm extremely curious to see if anything at all happens to Tilted Towers. You know, I would not expect anything to just because we've expected it many times. It could happen, though. And I mean, if it did, would you be upset Tilted Towers was gone? I mean, I'm not really sure. It's been such a staple of Fortnite ever since it came into the game, and I don't know how I would feel if it weren't there. You know, I'm sure it would be fine. It would probably bring back a lot of that old school Fortnite feel because you would just land at places that weren't tilted. You know, right now, if you're going for straight action, the number one place you land is Tilted. If Tilted weren't there, you could send it retail, you could send it to Pleasant, you could send it everywhere much more often, and I kind of feel like that would be fun. But anyway, hopefully you guys have a great day. I'll catch you in the next video, and until then, take it easy and peace out.